Ooh, what's up, guys? My name is Vibe. So grab some snacks, relax, and don't forget to stay hydrated. We're playing Freedom Planet today. I'm a huge fan of classic Sonic. Like, Sonic 3 and Knuckles and Sonic Mania are some of my favorite games. And I heard this game was pretty similar to those. I'm gonna try and full screen it. So that's really loud. That is so loud, what the heck? Okay, that seems like it's better. Huh. Close enough for now.
In fact, you should be proud. Your son is moments away from inheriting the throne.
Dale! I tried, Father.
What do you want with us?
How shall I explain this? I'm gifting your son with my knowledge. It will make him the most powerful ruler your world has ever known. And he will answer to no one but me.
Oh. Yo, Snatcher, like from a hat in time. Yo. Also, jeez. It's pretty dark.
For centuries, we have depended on the Kingdom Stone, but its strength is fading. It cannot keep up without growing demand for energy. The Prince of Shuigang, poisoned with madness over the death of his father, has spread machines across the land. To steal energy from other kingdoms. Tensions are growing, and I fear that war may be inevitable.
Options. Full screen. Adventure mode mixes story and gameplay. Plays every. Adventure mode mixes story and gameplay. Classic mode plays every stage in order. Classic mode. I have no idea what the difference between these two is, but I guess this one. I don't know, their design seems a lot more similar to Sonic. So. X is attack, Z is jump. Whoa, when that bar is full, C is that. Oh, that's pretty cool. So it's kind of like a dash like move. So there's no like spin dash or super peel out. There's no directional attack. Well, there is a down kick. Oh, but you can angle the dash. That's pretty cool. I guess like the Spark games are like Sonic Adventure 3, basically. So I'd say this is like classic Sonic. So I guess like Sonic 5. Okay, this game seems like it could be super cool. It seems like it has a higher focus on combat than most, than the classic Sonic games, but still pretty cool and still has a bunch of momentum elements. Nice. I just think it would be really nice if we had like some sort of like spin dash or peel out move to get momentum a lot quicker. Yeah, this is pretty cool. Although it doesn't really seem like these stages were designed with momentum really in mind. They seem like a lot more like classic platformer stages like Mario, but maybe maybe that'll change soon. But yeah, the momentum parts that we've had so far are super cool. Like, I'm not against platforming in momentum games. Like, Sonic 3 and Sonic Mania have a lot of that, and I really like those games. Oh, that's pretty cool. Those are like those steam jets from Metropolis Zone in Sonic 2. Oh, well, that's a really simple boss. Okay, honestly, this system with the blue bar, first having to fill it up and then you get a big momentum boost, I like it. Yeah, this game is pretty fun. I personally think, at least right now in the game, that Spark 1 is better, but this game is still really good. I don't know, it might just be me, but this character feels a little bit slow. I don't really know why. It's like, there definitely is, like, momentum and pretty high speed gameplay going on. But She just feels, like, kind of slow. That was pretty cool though. Like, just being able to walk up walls like that is kind of weird. Like, I understand why you can do that, because there isn't really, like, a super easy momentum gain, like a spin dash or a peel out. But we do still have that dash that's constantly refilling, so for free momentum, so yeah, I don't really understand that too much. I like how they give a visual indicator of how much air you have instead of just a timer that's constantly counting down that you couldn't really see, like in Sonic. I like that. See, now this is a pretty fun speed gameplay section. Honestly, this part of the level reminds me a lot of Sonic 3 and Knuckles Hydrosity Zone. Good amount of platforming, but also a lot of speed-based gameplay. And that's the type of stuff I really like in Sonic games. Good platforming and a pretty good amount of speed-based gameplay. Also, this boss music slaps, dude. This boss theme goes hard. Oh, I'm about to die. I'm on one health. Yep, okay. Okay, I need to stop getting hit by those stupid bendy trees. I guess this game does have more focus on platforming rather than momentum, which I'm okay with. And I do like that it also incorporates high amounts of momentum into it. I just personally kind of prefer mostly momentum and a medium amount of platform to a medium amount of momentum and a high amount of platforming. Like, don't get me wrong, I like platforming. Kirby is one of my favorite series, and it's pure platforming. Well, and some combat, but yeah. Oh, that was pretty cool, though. That was a pretty cool snipe with the dash. Yeah, this game is very fun. This is a pretty cool boss fight. Oh, was it supposed to lag like that, or? That was some big lag. Yeah, that's pretty cool. The music in this is pretty good, which I'd expect from a Sonic-like. Dragon Boost finish? What? Okay, this level already seems like it's gonna be fun. You have to do both high speed momentum and platforming if you want to really do well on this level. This level reminds me more so of Aquatic Ruin, probably a lot because the visual design. Oh, that's pretty cool. Okay. Interesting. What is this? Oh, I'm locked in here now. Okay. I think the reason why this game feels a bit slower is because this character that we're playing as can't pick up momentum up on her own as well as like Sonic or Spark can. I need to stop getting hit by stuff. I'm really starting to like this boost dash, though. Oh. The shield. Okay. well. Yes, I know that I have to go over there, Arrow. Thanks. Well, that doesn't help. Oh, that's pretty cool. There's a thing there. Well, now we're just back where we started. There we go. Okay. Oh, we have to go through both of these doors. Okay. I see. Okay, cave area. All these pulleys remind me a lot of Flying Battery Zone from specifically Free and K, not really as much of Mania's. Oh, okay. Oh, you get a 1-up at 200 money in this game. Okay. I mean, I guess that makes sense considering you also don't lose money when just when getting hit. And also it's everywhere, so yeah. Also, I don't think this shield has, like, prevented me from getting hit. So what's the point of this? Like, I'm not really understanding what's up with this shield. He stole the yellow Chaos Emerald. Or copyright free version, Anarchy Gem. Oh, that's just it? Okay. Oh, well. There are more yellow Anarchy Gems there. Okay, I guess we go. Into the mines. Minecraft. Let's go. Wait, that. You think I wouldn't see that? How do I get into that? Okay, I'm just not gonna try. Oh, that gave me invincibility, okay. Okay, invulnerability, not invincibility, because stuff doesn't die when I touch it. Alrighty then. Mr. Wall Destroyer out here. Yes, give me health. Thank you, kind flower that I brutally murdered. Oh, drill. Okay. Whoa, why does the drill have such powerful springs attached to it? Okay. Slamming into stuff and destroying it with the dash is very fun. This screams boss encounter. Or you can just leave. Okay. Ah! Where'd that pickaxe come from? Die. Die, you stupid turtle thing. I don't know what you are. You're annoying. That's what. Okay, I guess the pickaxe just has a continuously active hitbox. This reminds me a lot of Hidden Palace or Lava Reef Zone Act 2. Also of the it also reminds me of the ice area in the game Spelunky. Okay, this is another one of those places where you have to go through both sides in order, both doors in order to progress. Okay, I see it. What's up with that red lamp? Oh, you have to kill an ostrich skeleton. I see. Oh, I get it. It's like the boss of flying. Nope, never mind. I thought we had to get it to hit itself. No. Turns out we just had to. Okay. Well, that's I think that's done now. Yep. Where's the green door? Here. Yep. Okay, give me this. Yes, health. Thank you. Okay, and now we just activate this. Oh, yep. Who could have seen that coming? The spike floor rises. I'm dying. Okay. Wow, the red door is really easy, but then the blue, the green door is really hard. You're just gonna wanna go. No. What? I had full health. Almost full health. How did I explode? What caused me to explode there? Wait. Oh, you have an up attack? That's pretty cool. That's also very useful. You have like kind of like a Captain Falcon or Fire Emblem Sword Fighter up B. That's pretty cool. No. Go. Jeez, what the heck? That section's so stupid. Okay, well, we made it out. I have like 1 HP, but we made it. What? So you can only do the up attack while grounded. That's definitely not counterproductive. Counterintuitive. Thank you. Okay. Is that done? Okay, and we're back up to 5 lives. That green section took so many of my lives, dude. Who's that, bro? Give me back that crystal. You know, that chaos diamond isn't yours. Hey there, spider boss from Metroid Fusion. I didn't expect to see you here. I see, that's how it keeps up. It has insane jump speed. This is a really long boss arena. Okay, how do I damage you? Ah, I cut off your arms. Gonna try and bite me with its face. Just its entire fight. Its entire face. Okay. Ah, jeez. You got your arms back? What the hell? That's not fair. My guy, you stupid, like, ant. Die. Why does it keep getting its, like, arms back, bro? That's so annoying. Okay, we are starting to deal damage to it though. Like, one of its eyes just went out. Yeah, that's how you tell if you're doing damage to a robot boss, if parts of its body just start turning off. That's not a joke, that is just the best way to tell if you're dealing damage to a robot-based boss. No, do I have to... Okay, good, I don't have to redo that whole thing. Wow, this game is pretty hard. It's kind of weird, like, the mainline Sonic games aren't really that difficult. Like, even a lot of the final zones aren't that hard. But then the Sonic inspired games like Freedom Planet and Spark are actually pretty hard. do I hit it? It's doing its stupid biting attack. Yeah, this is pretty fun. This game doesn't have as many like highly momentum based sections as the classic Sonic games do, but it's still a fun game and it is an overall good platformer. Stupid ant, stop jumping around. Okay. One of its eyes broken. Stop jumping around like a 5-year-old on trampoline. You are so annoying. Okay, but it should be down to its last hits. Because look, both its sides are destroyed now. Okay, let's go. Yo, that was a super stylish finish though. Hit both its arm, like cut off its arm and hit its face with one dash. Now that's cool. Okay, and this cave has come down. Time to get out of here. Noah unlocked. What are all these things? Fortune Knight. I'm going to assume that's like this version, this game's version of Casino Knight. Should I have played in adventure mode and not classic mode? Am I like missing out on the story because I played classic mode? like, the only thing that I know is that, like, someone stole, like, an energy thing, and that is that a kingdom got taken over, and that now that kingdom is, like, stealing everyone's energy, or power plants, or something, and, like, yeah. Am I, like, missing out on important parts of the story? Go. Get exploded, nerd. Okay, this is a really fun level. Oh, lanterns. Huh, that's cool. How do you destroy that enemy type before they shoot you? Or do you just have to dodge their shot? Yeah, you probably just gotta dodge. I mean, it does have a big tail. Ow, that's a wall. Best commentary I know. Okay, give me health. I really like this game. This game has a pretty cool art style. I like can't read what any of these signs say. And I assume they're in Japanese, which I can't read. If we're in German, that wouldn't be a problem, because I fluently speak and read German. I'm fluent in German, but yeah. Okay, another slot machine. What do I get? Money. I really like all of the, like, the dragon theming in this level. It's very cool. Why can you go inside of the wall? That's dumb. Die. You die, you cheater. Yeah, fight me over here. Oh, multi-combo. Get destroyed, stupid. Okay, now I think I'm the stupid that's getting destroyed. What? Oh! Hey there, Sonic CD Stardust Speedway, Eggman. Oh. God, teabag him. He died by getting crushed. L. Oh. Never mind, he didn't die. Oh, there's crystals up here. Gimme. I like that these are actually like working escalators. Yeah, don't mind me, I'm just going on a shopping trip. Well, semi-working. If you don't jump onto them, you do just kind of clip through them. Whoa, what kind of a mall has a zip line? Alrighty. More slot machines. Whoa, what kind of a mall has a rave area near the ceiling? More malls gonna have this type of stuff. Okay, this is pretty fun. I like how one of the levels is just actually a store. Bike World? I wanna buy a bike. Gimme. Aw man, I can't buy a bike. Wahoo! I love it when stores have zip lines in them. It's my favorite, definitely very common occurrence. Ah yes, hot air balloons that you can grab into. All my favorite stores have those. Ah yes, piano panels. The thing all of my favorite stores have. Bounce, bounce. Destroy a speaker. And grab the zipline. Yeet. Okay, this game is really fun. A bit heavy on the walls, but besides that, very enjoyable. And also very nice pixel art. Secret wall. Very nice. Okay, and that is an actual wall there. Cool. Guess I go back. Guess I'm supposed to go up here. Whoa, that was cool. I like how the dash just lets you multi-hit destroy enemies. Wanna gamble. Cool. I have no idea what those things do, but I have more of them. I assume that's a good thing. Hey there, more fun version of Carnival Night Zone Act 1 boss fight. You're dead now. Haha, kaboom. Okay, Mr. Lizard, I'm gonna run from your stupid jaguar. Guy's deal, why does he hate me? Thank you for the health, I appreciate it. What is he saying? I literally can't hear what he's saying. Like, I hear that he's saying things, I just don't know what those things are. I think I heard the word rabbit in there somewhere. Okay, boss dead. Yes. Oh, I should probably move my cursor off the screen. Yippee. CPU finish. What? Sky Battalion. metal ship. Okay. Don't die. I think I'm dead. Yep. Jeez, bro, stop screaming, dude. I feel like the dash giving you like full invincibility is pretty strong. Also, ow. That, getting hit by that hurt. Note to self, don't get hit by that. I gotta stop getting hit by everything. Wait, man, I've already been here. What the heck? Is this supposed to like take the upper path? Okay. Oh, that's a lot of money. Yum. Money is nice. But yeah, the fact that the dash gives you full invincibility, yeah, that's pretty strong. How are you even meant to win this fight? You're just supposed to like bait that out and then... No, because he dodges it. What? What the heck? I shouldn't have grabbed those. What are you even supposed to do for this boss fight? I don't understand. I guess that... Pretty cool. Okay. Fire ship and earth ship. So that was metal ship. Sure, fire ship, I guess. Invincibility power up. Get slapped. What does that do? And now I have a shield. Oh, this shield pulls in hearts. Or feather crystals? Or leaf crystals? I don't know. Health. And this shield magnetizes money. Capitalism time, let's go. No, they took my capitalism. What are those, like, weird tokens that I'm always collecting? Okay, I have 41 of them. What do they do for me? Okay, boss. Oh, it's you. stop throwing your stupid cards and die. Stop being a coward and fight me up close. Instead of throwing your stupid cards at me like a nerd. If I have a ranged attack, sure, fight me at range. If I only have a melee attack, then, and if you fight me at range, then fuck you. Bro. Why are these boss fights so annoying? So he has attacks that I can't hit him, that make it so I can't hit him, and his attacks outrange me, which means I also can't really fight him like that. And then he also has a dash that gets him out of any form of danger. Sure. Explain to me why this is a fair boss fight. What the fuck? This is so stupid. Get me out of here. I guess there's nothing else to do but fight him. Nah. What you gonna do about it? instantly teleport away like the little bitch you are. I'm just gonna go up here. Who thought that this was gonna be a fun boss fight? What happens if I just stay up here? Can he even do anything? There's literally no good way you can fight him. Why can't he just randomly use that stupid card gun attack? I didn't mean to go down here. I wanted to grab the heart pieces up there. Game over? Yeah, I wonder why. Maybe it's because the boss is fucking stupid. Oh yeah, just put me right back into this boss fight. Okay. Thank you. Yeah, the... How? Okay, once you figured out the trick to the ant boss fight, it was actually pretty cool. But what's the trick to this boss fight? Just dodge the cards? Yeah, that's definitely cool. Oh, he died. Cool. Alrighty, on to the last one. Earthship. Except this one has a boss fight that isn't complete crap. Yes, health. Thank you. Appreciate the health a lot, thank you. Okay, what is this platform for? Ow. The heckin' crushers. I mean, I guess they did their job. The crusher crushed me. I mean, I guess I shouldn't have expected anything else from a crusher. I mean, I knew exactly what it was gonna do. This shield do? I can walk on spikes. Oh, that's useful. I'll just walk. Okay, boss fight. Okay, that's actually a pretty interesting concept for a boss fight. To wait for him to shoot down a spike, and then you can hit him after that. And that boss is already done. Cool. Yippee. Away I go. What? No. No. Really? Every single other time after the boss fight, you can just jump off the ship and then that'll win the level. But this one time, it's different. Okay then. Okay, you beat the boss now. What did you do every single other time after you beat the boss? Yep, you jumped off the ship. Oh, but don't do that this time, otherwise you'll die. What? Alright, and now I'm stuck down here. There we go. You have to like go up. So now do I go? Okay. What? You. What is that? Is that a peacock? Oh, it's the prince. Oh, cool, he just has a super laser attack that hits literally everywhere. I sure do love that.
You will face justice! Surrender! Not a chance! So, you chose to death. How pathetic!
Dude, those lightning balls are so hard to avoid because they are just massive. Okay, one more hit. One more feather. And stop dodging. Gotta go. that ultra laser attack is really annoying. One more feather. Yep. Now slap the bird. Said slap the bird. Go. Probably shouldn't have jumped there. Okay, dodge that. Oh, just stand between the lasers. Okay. For some reason, I thought the lasers would spin. I know it's goofy, but like, come on. Bird. Okay. This is actually a pretty cool boss fight. I'm just gonna not. Like, okay, I think the reason, like, Sonic Spark only has one run state, and that's fast. Sonic has three. Walk / jog, medium run, and sprint. This character only has walk / jog and medium run. No sprint state. Which is, I think, why she feels so slow in comparison to Sonic and Spark. Also, this is the only Sonic and Spark game that I've played that actually has voice acting. So that's pretty cool. Hold on, let me just heal up. Okay, cool. That did damage. Your bird's true power, not yours. The bird's the one doing that, not you. You're doing nothing. laser attack. Okay, just, yep. Just stand still in one place and dodge it. His ultimate attack can be dodged by standing completely still. Kind of ironic that you have to move more to dodge his normal attacks than you have to do for his quote-unquote ultimate attack. Bro. Yeah, this is a hard game. Okay, the platforming itself isn't like that hard, and it's actually pretty fun. But then the boss fights really ain't it. Don't push me off the ship. I disagree with that decision of yours. Go. Okay. Let me slap that last feather. There we go. Oh, I double slapped the feather and the bird at the same time. Okay, laser attack. Yep, I'll just stand here. Go. Yippee. Wahoo, run. Jeez, dude. Like, why do his attacks do so much damage? Go, do the dash. Bird slap. Okay. My one problem with this fight is that when you're hitting the feathers, it's hard to tell when he's charging up the lightning ball. Also, what happens to her face whenever you turn? Like, whenever you turn at a high speed, her face becomes weird. Okay. Yep. Nah, I'll just stand still. It's like this boss is hard but fair. Well, would be if his attacks did one damage at a time instead of two. We've all chosen death just by living, because, like, living, it has the upside of being alive, but it has the downside of a guaranteed death. Okay, nope, I'm not falling off the ship. See that I didn't have full meter there. Okay. Just don't fall off the ship. Okay, good. Don't stand in the lasers. Wow, so difficult to dodge. Just don't stand in the lasers. Like, literally, the lightning ball attack is harder to dodge than his ultimate attack. If you're not bad. Unfortunately for me, I am bad. Hits does this guy actually take? Cause, like, we've gotten him to free hits and then we've died every time after that. One, okay, that's two. Nah, I don't think I will actually. Okay, you can either have egregiously hard bosses that take lots of tries, or a lives like this, or a lives system. You can't have both. Both just leads to an experience that is not fun. Bro, what the heck? She waited so long before she did her dash. That's annoying. One more feather that I still have to slap, okay. Just dodge that. Okay, slap the bird. And go up. Platform. Wow, so incredible. I just gotta slap the bird. That's a new voice line. New voice line unlocked. Red mean? Does that just mean that he's on his final hit? Hopefully, that just means that he's on his final hit. Ah, keep running! No, die! No! Ah, heck. Okay, but I think he was on his final hit. So that's good, at least. Okay, also, if you have infinite lives, then what's the point of a... Like, if you have infinite continues, what's the point of a life system? There's not even, like, really power-ups that you lose when you die. So why not just have infinite lives? If the lives don't mean anything. Okay. Slap bird. We dodge. Wahoo. Oh. Huh. I thought he had already done three of them. Anyways, yeah. This isn't really the game I expected it to be. It's still fun. But I expected it to be... have a higher focus on momentum. Because this game is mainly just a platformer with momentum elements, whereas Sonic and Spark are full-on momentum platformers. Hell, I'd say Spark is even mostly a momentum game with some platforming elements. I guess three different sides of the same coin. Sonic is a mix of both. Well, classic Sonic is a mix of both platforming and momentum. Freedom Planet is mostly platforming with some momentum. And Spark is mostly momentum with a good amount of platforming. I guess you could say, for a more Sonic-like comparison, three sides of the same sign. Come on, three more feathers that I have to hit. One, two, hit that last one. Okay, now it's just the bird that we have to hit, hopefully the last time. Yes! Let's go! Let's go! Bird slap.
This is far from over!
Woohoo! That's how it's done. Yippee! That's how it's done? Die like 50 times? Okay, whatever you say. Bonus. Oh. Ledge taunt, free faller. I have no idea what those mean. What? Oh, because I have the fire shield, I don't have to worry about those. Falling platform. Wow. Yay, I attract money now. Oh, that's a ceiling. Okay, I thought it was a semi-solid. Police? What? Why was there a police siren? That don't make sense. Yippee, lives, or health, I guess. Yo, chests underwater? What is this? Mario 64? Wahoo, bubble shield. Okay, I guess we just continue going this way. And then we go up. Okay, and a slope. Wahoo! I like slopes in momentum games. They give momentum. Looking dude. Yo, he looks like your mom. That's crazy. Also, I'm pretty sure I'm stuck. No, I'm not. Okay, cool. I just had no idea where to go. Okay, cool. Oh, a lot of money and health. Oh, that is nice. I guess Sonic Spark and Freedom Planet also are free up, are free sides of the same sign in terms of, like, combat. Like, Sonic doesn't really have that much of combat focus, but does have combat. Freedom Planet has some combat, but also has more combat, has deeper combat than Sonic, but still isn't the main focus. And Spark actually has, like, a pretty high amount of combat. Jeez, what are the police doing here, bruh? I didn't break no laws, bruh. What you doing, bruh? Slap him. Well, they left. Cool. I ain't getting arrested today. There ain't no arrest warrant out for Lilac. I think that's her name. That's what it said at the on the character select screen at the beginning, didn't it? Okay, where do I go now? I see I have to get up there. Didn't mean to do that. I bonked off the ceiling, heck. The music of this level reminds me of Sonic CD's title Tempest. I don't remember which version of title Tempest, though. I'd say the series that consistently have the best game music are probably Sonic and Doom. At least in my opinion, because rock and metal are two of my favorite genres, and those series have a lot of that music. But also just in general, people seem to agree that Sonic games often have great music and that and Doom music is also beloved by many. Also, like, Sonic, how many other series can say that they have, that they relatively consistently don't have super great games, yet still remain super relevant and popular, and also have great music? Like, what other series, what other major franchise can say that? None. Like, the Doom franchise almost died from just one bad game. And if you're a Sonic fan, you know just how many bad games Sonic has had. I guess you are supposed to lose that fight. Also, this level is called Tade Creek. The heck is a Tade? Okay. I guess it just has a... Jade Creek. I guess it just has a goofy death animation. Okay, cool. Yeah, the boss fights in this game really, they really are just difficult. She has a different shield this time. Jeez. Still, like, that boss fight is a lot more fair than a lot of the others. But fair and easy are two very different things. Jeez, dude. Like, once you learn the patterns, this fight becomes relatively simple. Never mind. hadn't moved as much, I would have been fine.
I won't give up. Let's go.
But see, a fight like that, that's actually a fair fight. I learned from Celeste that upwards diagonal dodges get you more range than straightforward dodges or dashes. Kind of funny how she has a spear, but she mostly just uses these ice discuses for her attacks. Don't jump there. Beat the boss fight. Can I please have some health? Ah, thank you. Just run. Oh, that's a frog. Right, I nuked the frog. I love how some enemies you can just stand on and then they just explode. Up here. Ha 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 ha. This dash allows for so much movement in platforming. Slap. But yeah, this silvery gray metal shield is really strong. It just basically negates all sources of damage. Oh, okay, I'm about to die. Never mind, thank you for the health crystals. Haha. Fast running, go brr. Wow, I can breathe underwater now. Ain't that wacky? Kinda goofy, kinda crazy, kinda maybe a little bit even silly. Even underwater. It even works underwater. It's like flex tape. Feel swift here with flex tape. Flex tape has such a strong adhesive, it even works underwater. That's crazy. We here I go. Slap a flower for money. Oh no, am I gonna have to fight the stupid card boss again? Please say I don't have to fight the card boss again. Okay, good, I don't think I do. Oh no, it's the lizard. Wait, it's a snake, not a lizard. Ah. Yeah, I probably shouldn't jump on top of his super fast firing gun. You know, don't think that's really my best idea. Got you now, Spider-Man! I like how you can just kind of combo the snake sometimes. I need to remember not to do that. Oh. Oh, I didn't realize I had an ally in this fight. That's cool. It's a 2v1, and yet I still lost. I want pictures of Spider-Man! Looking slappable, you stupid lizard. Yeah, boss fights really aren't the best part of this game. Okay, that felt pretty cool though, outrunning the falling bullets. Like, that just looks so cool. I'm a sucker for cool and stylish gameplay. Soldiers are so annoying, dude. Okay, after I beat this boss, I'm gonna end stream because I do have a little bit of homework I still have to do. And also I want to do more of my day than just stream this game. I might stream this game again, I might not. If I don't, I'll probably just play it casually. It is a fun game. I have to remember, don't jump onto that. I remind myself to not jump onto that, and then I instantly jump onto it. Okay. Okay. Well, that's just not fair. How did that scoop me up, dude? You ain't the ice cream man. You shouldn't be getting scoops. Rose laughing like Raiden after he stabbed himself to activate Jack the Ripper. Okay. You have 10 minutes to say anything. General Serpentine makes a rather satisfying sound when you hit him. Have you beaten this game before? No, this is my first playthrough. Also, Bat Blaster Wing, thank you for the follow. Hello. The stupid soldiers, man. Soldiers are so annoying to try and kill, because there's two of them. people. After he sends two Shade Elites. After you, okay. I assume those are the soldiers. Why do I always... Oh my god. Every time. I know I shouldn't jump into that. And yet, every time I do. Why am I like this? Why am I like this, dude? I do like that you can kind of sometimes combo him a little bit. Well, at least this game gives you unlimited continues and lets you restart each continue from the last checkpoint. That is true. But, like, if you're gonna give me unlimited continues, then what's the point of even having a live system? I'd say, like, your game can either have really hard boss fights or... like really hard levels and boss fights, or a live system. It just doesn't make sense to have both from a game design perspective. Because if you have infinite lives, then you don't really risk losing anything from dying, which is good with harder bosses. When your game has harder bosses and levels. But then, if it has easier bosses and levels, then, like, there's no reason to even use those infinite lives. But limited lives and hard bosses can just lead to frustration. Lives are a holdover from the arcade days. I know that. And I guess the only thing dying in this game is add to the counter you see after you beat the game. Yeah. Like, I get that lives are a holdover from the arcade days. Like, I mean, not even just the arcade days, from even just, like, the days of the early consoles, like the Genesis or the NES. But, yeah, modern games are moving further and further away from live systems. Especially with the rise of open world games, lives really don't matter anymore in that type of game. And, like, don't get me wrong, I understand the importance of lives in games. they make you not want to die as much. Trust me, I know why lives are in games. I play a lot of classic games, like from Game Boy, Genesis, Super Nintendo. And I understand why lives are important to those games. But like, having a live system but then giving you infinite continues also is kind of weird. It falls into like that New Super Mario Bros. Thing, where all it does is add to a counter that doesn't mean anything. I think continuing in the sequel takes a chunk out of your shard collection. I haven't played in a while and you haven't gotten very far in Freedom Plan 2 either. Okay. Yeah. I'd say Freedom Planet, the classic Sonic games, and Spark the Electric Jester games are like similar sides of the same idea, momentum platforming. Sonic is a good balance between both. Freedom Planet is more focused on platforming, and Spark is very heavily focused on speed. And I feel like the same thing can also be said about the combat in those games. Classic Sonic, combat isn't really that big of a focus. Freedom Planet, combat is like a medium focus. In Spark, combat is a pretty big focus. Okay. Are you playing this on a keyboard or a controller? Keyboard? I'm playing on a keyboard. Yeah. I'd probably be playing this on a controller if I had a working controller, but one of the buttons on one of the bumpers on my controller stopped working. It just died. So I'm working on fixing that. But until then, yeah, just keyboard. Too much Celeste and Splatoon wore out the button. Dang it. Kinda ran into that though. You need to fix your controller too. Your old USB controller has a button stuck. Sure, how old is that controller? Ever heard of Radio Shack? Yes. Aren't they like out of business? Ow. Yeah, they've been out of business for years, so the fact that it's their house brand just shows how old it is. Wow, yeah. The controller I was using was a knockoff Switch Pro controller that just happened to have a USB connectivity. getting pinged on Discord. What? Okay, whatever. This is a pretty hard boss fight. Like, don't get me wrong, I'm not against, like, hard levels or very difficult parts of levels. I mean, I beat Celeste and loved every second of it. But yeah. how many hits does that helicopter take? Okay. Also, it feels just kind of weird to play like a Sonic inspired game. Felt like some kind of like spimble, like spin dash or boost or something like that. Like Spark has the Jester dash, Sonic obviously spin dash, peel out. This game, closest thing is the blue dash. That's not spimble at all. That's a new attack. Cool. The dragon boost runs for the special meter, so no spamming it. Doesn't it grant iframes? Pretty sure it does. And I'm just saying that I'm used to every like Sonic-like game having some sort of just quick snowball boost option. Like in Sonic you have like spin dash, drop dash, peel out, rolls. In Spark you have gesture dash and air dash. Okay, this is the most health I've ever had going into phase 2. Okay, I've been streaming for almost 3 hours. I have homework I should probably do. Yeah. So I'm gonna end stream now. I'll be back streaming on on March 25th. Yeah, probably either this game or A Hat in Time. And until then, remember to stay chill, stay vibin', don't forget to stay hydrated. See ya!